One of the ways para maging more effective tayo sa ating daily walk with the Lord, yung talaga may focus natin ang sarili natin sa Panginoon, in spite of the busyness of our schedules, and we all know na kapag holiday season, talaga namang daming nangyayari, maraming nagaganap. So the key here is to really distinguish between a situation and a problem or challenge. A situation, bali, is something na hindi mo talaga kontrolado and there's nothing you can do to change it. So mayroong mga bagay sa buhay natin that are ika nga unchangeable or it's not within our full control para baguhin o ayusin. You know, it's a situation that has come upon us. Yun. So learn to distinguish kung ang isang bagay o nangyayari sa buhay mo is a situation. And so instead of being negative and complaining about it, siyempre a situation is simply something that you do your best to adapt, to adjust, to to accept, no? But this is different from a problem or a challenge. A problem or a challenge, bali, is something na may magagawa ka naman talaga. It's something within your control and responsibility. So let me just give you an example, okay? Yung paggising sa umaga, kunyari, or kung mas maaga ka ba gigising, or whatever, o anong oras ka matutulog. These are what you might call problems or challenges, no? Kasi ikaw naman talaga may control noon kung anong oras ka gigising at kung anong uunahin mong gagawin pagkagising mo. Now, compare that kunyari with the situation. For example, sunod-sunod ang mga okasyon o mga activities na ika nga na i-invite ka lang or let's say na you are in that kind of situation na not within your full control, no? Merong ibang mga tao ang may pananagutan doon sa situation na yun. So you cannot just change it, no? Kasi it's beyond your power. So sa buhay natin, in our Christian life, learn to distinguish between a situation and a problem or challenge. If it's a situation, you just have to learn how to give thanks to God in spite of the difficulty siguro and learn to adjust or adapt to it, diba? Pero if it's a problem, no, then that means there is a solution. So kailangan maging solution-oriented ka. Huwag ka naka-focus doon sa problem. Now, often what happens is that merong situation that causes a problem. So, halimbawa, kung ikaw ay nagtatrabaho at yung schedule medyo kakaiba, it may cause a problem for you. But learn to distinguish between the two. So, susi lang dyan is to identify which part of the ika nga na predicament is really a situation beyond your control and which part of it is simply just a problem or a challenge na kung ifo-focus mo lang yung sarili mo, you can actually solve it by the grace of God. And you can ask God for wisdom para tulungan kanya dun sa problem na yun. So again, to be effective, to be productive din sa Christian life mo, learn to distinguish between a situation that is really beyond your control and a problem or a challenge that is really within your control kung iisipan mo lang talaga or by the grace of God if you would pray and ask God for wisdom. So blessings sa inyo at na nakikinig sa ating soul tips and until next time. Bye-bye.